Hey, YouTubers! Well, welcome to Deborah Star Trek Enterprise Refit Prop Reproduction number 68. And right now, this beast is 80% prismated. And I'll show you what I mean. We'll go over what's been done, which is the entire there's that egg McMuffin. Secondary hull, except for the top here. Pylons, bottoms, and all that. And I'm going to do the top of the pylons, top of the secondary hull, just that ridge back here, as a separate section, and then the warp engine. So today is Wednesday. I imagine I will be done by this weekend as far as the prismation goes. Next week begins decal stage. Now I'm still trying to find out what's going on with the display case. That's the only possible hurdle we could run into right now. Because lack of communication, I don't know what's going on over there. They've never messed me over before, but if anything happens, it'll be because of that. We are looking tentatively now at Sunday, March 22nd departure to Arizona for delivery with an arrival there of February 27th. And then we just zoop back here on a plane on Sunday, the 1st of March. That's about the way it's going to go. Then I'm going to have at least a week or two interim part where I have a couple side things I got to do for friends. And then I will start the next project, which I believe is the last Starfighter gunship. And this puppy has lasers and all that. Now, even though it's not as big as this, it's fairly complex and it should be a really cool build. I've always wanted to build that, and it'll be nice to add it to the gallery. Other news. Lillian Place definitely said, I believe, it's Wednesday the 10th or the 11th. For an evening paranormal romp, which your intrepid ghost hunters, Steve Pac-Man, the cameraman, and yours truly, Papa Smurf, and we hope to run into some stuff. Definitely interested in that. What else? Thinking. Oh yeah, so the green screen stuff and the party I've talked about for people locally that'll be able to attend. All that's going to happen fairly quickly. So if we're looking at, you know, departure the 22nd, you can imagine the party will be the 19th or the 20th here. And before I leave on the 22nd, there will be green screen grabs for the big contest to do an animated film using the green screen content that I'm going to make available, which results in a prize of a brand new NX-01 kit, still sealed in a box, first edition, which has the pretty red box. $100 cash, and of course, lots and lots of kudos and hoorahs and all that, not to me, you know, and mentioned in the credits and mentioned in the video, and I would just laud all kinds of praise upon you. And I'm sure there's two or three guys I know that are in my Facebook family that are just really talented at that. You know what I'm talking about, Nick and Richard, you know, you guys. I expect probably one of you to win, although you never know. New people come along and they know what they're doing sometimes. There's some real sharpies in my crew, and I'm really happy that some of these people's talents is occasionally aimed my way, and very wonderful people. So let's see. I'm trying to think. This is on the fly. Mama Smurf is home, but she said, yeah, go ahead and make a video. She doesn't feel well. On small nonsense news, the big fridge here that was always been my way is gone because I bought Mama a great big stainless steel fridge, a great big one. And although it's going to take years to pay it off, because you could park a plane in this thing, I have gained back some shelf space and a little bit of breathing space. So now it's only the washer and dryer we have to figure out. I guess I have to build a whole room for that, but that'll come later. and so, departure date, February 22nd. We arrive at the client's house, February 27th. Back here, March 1st. Gonna go through New Orleans, I think during Mardi Gras. So, you know, professor walking down Mardi Gras, you know, Bourbon Street and all that. That should be hilarious. We're going somewhere in Texas. I know we're going to Roswell, New Mexico, the little alien inn. I've always wanted to go there. We are going to Flagstaff, Arizona, and then descending down to Phoenix to our client, Robert, who has been wonderful and patient and very supportive of my efforts. And so now I'm going to try to set up the light so you can see the prismatics. The prismatics are tricky, and today is a crap day. It is cool and not sunny at all, so I don't exactly know how I'm going to do it. Maybe I'll get the lasers out and try something trick, but let's move on. Okay, so we'll try to avoid making this another nausea ride. I've got quite a few light sources here because I'm trying to duplicate the sun. And as you can see out there, it's a gloomy, cold day.
So anyways, moving on. Trying to get a look at these prismatics here. And it takes a certain angle to see them. They're very subtle, actually. You know, they just look like sort of slightly darker, or lighter, I should say, Aztec features on the ship when you look at them directly without any light. And the microphone just hit the sensor. I don't know if you heard that or not. So there you go on this side, and of course the pylons as well. So next we're going to, trying to avoid hitting the thing, this back area right here, and of course the upper pylons of the warp engines, but all else is on. Now notice here I have very little light, and see, you can barely tell there's any of them there. Just sort of a hint. And that has to do with the interference paints only reacting when there's direct light, and also at a particular angle, I've noticed. So how I applied the paint at one angle I did, which is mostly straightforward. However, wherever I angled and all that, it'll react in a different way. It's very interesting, actually. You can see the edge stuff. Of course, you can't, again, up here, see my example. Just looks like some dull extras. Until the light starts to hit it right there, you see it. It's a very cool effect. I really like that. It certainly tops off the entire thing. And, of course, these blue sections here and all that. Now, is it canon? No. Again, I free flow on this. There are some elements that I saw that I know were there in those particular colors. But I had a lot of fun with it. I want it to be my work. I don't want it to be a Xerox copy. So hence, you get a whole lot of accuracy and a little bit of whimsical. I don't think anybody's going to have a problem with that. As many of you guys have agreed with me. See here, you can barely tell there's anything. I've agreed with me that the paint scheme has changed so much and so toned down that really an accurate paint scheme, geez, you know, I'm not sure what that means at this point. I think you should just have fun with it. And in my instance, it's kind of like producing something that is my vision of it, what I saw on screen, what I kept in my mind, and how it looks correct to me. No more, no less. So anyways, kids, as I pull back here without knocking stuff over. So kids, this is update number 68. And next time you see this, she'll be fully prismated. And I'll be starting on the decals. And then when that display comes in, hopefully, it'll be time to start grooving. Sorry kids, weather's getting crappy, it's getting late, no funny today. But next time I'm sure I can come up with something. Maybe the professor will sing again. Oh, God, no. Although, I gotta say, my mom and dad really liked it. They loved Chuck Cocker. They turned me on to all that music when I was a kid. Anyways, Papa's signing off. And yes, that is very good dog food. See you guys next time. Later.
Hello, boys and girls. Yes, your old friend, the professor. Well, Papa Smurf, he wasn't too happy about me attacking Steve Neal's place, so I'm in the doghouse again. And I plan on being here for probably a little while. They took away my intercontinental ballistic and plasma weapons. I can only hope I have them returned because you know what I'm planning. Smurfs and, you know, World War III and all that. And, I don't really know what's going. I think I'm almost forgiven. But no. I think it's going to take a little longer. Goodbye, boys and girls.